Authkit just added permissions, which means that you can now implement RBAC for all of your million free monthly active users. This video is everything that you need to know to get started with role-based authorization in your applications. Let's get into it. For this tutorial, we're using the next-authkit-example app. Here you'll find instructions for cloning and setting up the application. And once set up, it looks like this, running locally. The first thing you need to know is that permissions are now available on user sessions. We can see this in the source app account page source file. Using authkit next to get the user session, we now have user, role, and permissions, which we can hover to see its type, undefined, or an array of strings. After signing into our application, we can visit the account page where we see our user data, our role, but no permissions. So let's go into our WorkOS dashboard under roles to create new permissions. Now, when I see new forms like this, I'm always a little bit worried that I'm going to screw something up. So I'll give you a little guidance on how to use these fields, but we have a wonderful article that goes into much more detail. Let's say that we want to add a post viewer role. The name field is required, but can be changed later on if you come up with a better name. Slug, on the other hand, is the technical string that we're going to use inside of our application to permit or restrict different behaviors. So I'll use database and CRUD style language, saying that for posts, we want to permit read access. Finally, the description is optional, but helpful for providing additional information. I'm going to leave it blank for now, though. So we have our viewer permission. Let's add a full access permission. For now, I'll call this a post admin. And for the resource type of posts, they have full access. Great. Now I have two permissions. Now, one thing to note is that these slugs are immutable. So even though we can change the name and description, the slug can be edited after creation. Now that we have our permissions set up, let's go about adding them to roles. In role-based access control, the best practice is to run your authorization checks against permissions, not roles. However, you can't apply permissions directly to users. You apply them through roles. By default, every user in Authkit has a member role. So to apply permissions to that role, we navigate to the role we want to edit and add permissions. Here I'll select posts read and save. Now every user with that role has that new permission. Back in our application, we can validate that by signing out and signing back in. This is the account page. And here we go. We have both our role, member, and permission posts read. Okay, but why did I log out to log back in again? I did this to force refresh the session. By default, Authkit sessions refresh every 5 minutes, but that value can be configured based on your needs. For the sake of this tutorial, it's just easier to log out and log back in again. While we're in the WorkOS dashboard, let's jump back to roles and create a new admin role using lowercase admin as a slug and the description full system access. We'll add the permission posts all. Create our new role, find a user to assign it to, under organizations, edit role, change from member to admin. Now this user has an admin role, which changes the permissions that they have in the app. Jump back over to the app, sign out, sign in again, and see that our account now has an admin role with the updated permissions. And that's all there is to it. Now that you have permissions, you can do permissions checks against those string slugs and restrict or enable features based on those permissions. Of course, there are two things that I want to call out before leaving you. First and foremost, you'll want to use the latest version of our SDKs, whichever framework you are using. Second, you'll want to check out the documentation for roles and permissions. Here you'll find great suggestions on how to model your application, what to name the slugs depending on your application needs, and even suggestions on which delimiters to use. This is an extremely well-considered doc and you should give it a look. Okay, so we talked about roles, we talked about permissions. I think that's pretty much it for today, but we're currently in the middle of a series where we're integrating Authkit into any JavaScript framework. If that sounds like your jam, check out one of these videos over here. I'm Jantastic. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.